is an open NLK. So this subject will be learned by students as well as the CSE people. So basically we'll be having units of 5. So in the first unit we'll be learning about what is the introduction of IoT. So in the introduction of IoT, we'll be learning about what is actually IoT, which is nothing but Internet of Things. So the present trending technology, any grad student can learn the subject and they can go into the software field, as well as they can learn about the devices which are with sensors, actuators and many other devices which we are not done before. Okay. So in the introduction of IoT, we'll be learning about definition and all. And the second topic of this first unit is nothing but the characteristics. Characteristics of IoT. Because we have done all the connections, right? So we need a code to dump into that Arduino board where we see the output, right? So if let us take an example, like we want to switch on a washing machine or something. These are all embedded system examples, right? So the best example for embedded systems is nothing but washing machine or something. So we'll be just giving some time, like we'll be on the machine and all. So like let us consider ATM also. So this for this already the code will be inbuilt, like if you want to withdraw money or if you want to check the balance and all. So the like if consider the example of an ATM, right? So for writing a code for it, we'll be learning differently in this. So for writing the code for ATM, that is nothing but embedded system we'll be using. So here we'll be learning about the Python programming for doing all the interfacings between the Arduino as well as the Raspberry. So all the different programming languages we'll be learning, like Python and all we'll be learning in the and also the interfacing of the Raspberry Pi as well as the Arduino. We'll be learning in the third unit, and in the eighth, how the interoperability will be is done and all. We'll be seeing in the third unit. Okay. In the fourth unit, we'll be learning about the programming language we have learned already, right? So how the implementation part. So for the sensing elements will be there, right? So sensing devices. And also actuators. After the connection, how these sensing devices will be there and also actuators. And also we'll be learning about the software defined networks. Shortcut we can call it as SDN. So about this we'll be learning in the fourth unit. Okay. So till this fourth unit it will be completed. And so the fifth unit is nothing but totally about the application oriented, till like how we have learned the basics of IoT, and in this unit we have learned about the machine learning languages, and also the third unit we have learned about the programming languages. So the fifth unit is totally about the application oriented, like how this IoT can be used in the smart cities, the smart homes and all. So applications, all the applications we'll be seeing in the fifth unit, as well as we'll be learning about some case studies, like how this IoT can be used in the agriculture purpose. Agriculture purpose and also in the other fields, in the home, like we have seen. So how it will be used in the applications, and also some of the case studies we'll be learning in the fifth unit. So this is all about the 5 units, how the subject has been started, how it will be ended up in this. So like for every subject we'll be seeing, we'll be having the course objectives as well as the course outcomes. So for our subject, so the course objective is nothing but like we'll be learning about how the IoT has been came into existence, and we'll be learning about the different programming languages, and third point is nothing but how it can be applied in the real world. Okay, so the course objectives are nothing but what we are going to learn. So the course outcomes are nothing but what we'll be learning from this, and how can we apply after our course will be completed. Okay, so in this we'll be able to design the IoT application applications, and we can know how to interface a Arduino as well as Raspberry Pi. So these are the course for outcomes will be learning from the subject. Okay. So yeah, we'll be seeing that what is IoT. This IoT is nothing but Internet of Things. Knowing about Internet of Things, we will first see how this came into existence. So before it was like telemetry was there, and after that telemetry was there. After that, by using this embedded systems and all, we came to know how to use the some electronic devices like ATM and washing machines. So later on this became old, and Internet of Things came into existence, where this can be done with the virtual thing. So this will be dealing with the networks as well as the protocols we'll be having. So in this subject, basically we'll be learning about the coding as well as the interfacing of different devices and all, and also the application part. So till we'll be learning about how the networking will be done between the two devices, and what is the protocol for that. Okay, what are the steps we will need to follow for any designing and device and all. So after that, we'll be applying the same thing. After that, we'll be writing a program. So the programming.